This is what you call a good day at the recycling center. I was actually here earlier today, but when I saw this, I knew I had to come back and get this on video. This is the most stuff I've ever seen here. You have your typical assortment of Dell Pentium 4 PCs, inkjet printers, CRT TVs, a broken turntable, another inkjet printer, coffee maker, LCD monitors, typewriters. There's probably a DVD player down there. It looks like a fax machine under that. What is this? It's a Magnavox computer monitor with a bunch of mud on it. Somebody cut the cord on it, of course. There's another old computer monitor. It looks like a TV, but it's actually a monitor. You can see it has S-video and composite inputs on it. Of course, somebody cut the cord on that as well. Cordless phone handset. Equalizer. Water cooler. Window fan. Dehumidifier. Another Dell PC. Speakers, TV sets, keyboards, random box of junk, typical Juster computer speakers from the 90s, hi-fi speaker system, yeah right, those things sound like crap. Another box of junk, surge protector of the cord cut off. Some kind of no-name PC, laser printer, a couple portable DVD players, old Dell PC, there's a compact desk pro, a huge CRT TV sitting upside down. Somebody grabbed that Macintosh SE, I can't believe it. That's why I had to get this on video. You can see there's a couple old Macs here. This one is a Performa 6400. Not particularly interested in that model. Nothing really that special or valuable about it. Likewise, this Power Macintosh 8500. I have one just like it. And this was missing the faceplates. And here is a Power Mac 5500. It's one of those huge all-in-one Power Macs from before the iMac. And these things weigh about 70 pounds, so I'm not taking that. That's just too big. These were mostly sold to schools, and I think they purposely made it that heavy so a fifth grader couldn't steal one. But there was a Macintosh SE here earlier today. And now it's gone, and I didn't take it, so somebody else did. And one of these 44 megabyte cartridge drives. Don't really have a use for that, and I don't have any cartridges for it anyway. So let me show you what I already got in my trunk. And I already brought some stuff home, so I'll get some video of that as well. Otherwise, nothing really that valuable, and most of this stuff has the cords cut off anyway. Here's my Scooby. Let me show you what I have in the trunk. This is a Macintosh SE30. Whoever dropped these off was nice enough not only to wrap them in bubble wrap, but they even wrote what it is on the bubble wrap. And this is a Performa 6360, one of these little desktop systems. And this, would you believe it, is a color classic. I couldn't believe it when I saw it. I couldn't believe anybody would actually throw one of these out. Even if they're broken, they're worth quite a bit of money. And don't get your hopes up about this box, it's empty. It's an eMate 300. I found this here a couple months ago and it's been sitting in my trunk ever since. And so this is not all what I got. I already brought some stuff home, so I'll show you that once I get home. And by the way, what you saw there is definitely not typical. Like I said, that's the most I've ever seen there. 9 times out of 10 when I go there on weekends, there's either absolutely nothing there or there's just worthless junk like CRT televisions and VCRs and inkjet printers. So it's very, very rare that I would see that much stuff at the recycling center, which is why I had to come back and make that video. Here's the rest of what I got at the recycling center. This is a PowerBook 5300C, came with the power adapter. It's in very good condition and it works perfectly. I also got this iBook G3, one of their clamshell models with the handle. So a very distinctive design. Did not get the power adapter with it, and I don't have one that works with it, so I have to get a power adapter and then I can try it out, and I'll make a video about it when I do. Also looks like it's in very good condition. So I'll be looking forward to trying to get this one working. Only thing wrong is it's missing the little glossy logo in that cut out there. This one is loading up. It has Mac OS 8.1 on it. Came with the original battery, but I don't think it holds a charge anymore. And the floppy drive does work. I tested it. And back here is an Apple IIc. The one I did a video about a couple years ago, I sold to a fellow vintage computer enthusiast who was looking for one. So it's nice to have one of these again. This one is a ROM 3 version with the nice clicky keyboard. And it also works perfectly. This one finished loading, so you can see it has Mac OS 8.1, 32 megs of RAM. The hard drive is 800 megabytes. It has some applications on it, but not much. I couldn't find any personal documents on it either, so it's pretty clean installation. It has a PowerPC 603E processor running at 100 megahertz, so that's working fine. Did not get this with the power supply, so I'm just using a cheap aftermarket one that I got on eBay.